my YouTubians, Zodizians, Slayin' Saiyans, Cobra Kai's, and my pumpkin who be smashing. I'm Asherella. This is original Asherella. And when I sat down just a minute ago to do today's video, I had every intention of doing today's video on the song from Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness, Stumbling. But, you know, it's been a really high stress, really exhausting past couple of weeks, and Stumbling is one of those like tragically emotional and deep tracks, and I just don't have the emotional energy to properly share my thoughts and my feels on Stumbling. It's a short song, but it's got a lot of depth and emotion packed into it, so we're gonna do that one in a couple of days. And today, just last minute change, we're going to be listening to Take Me Down, also from Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. Now, Take Me Down is kind of special because, you know, it does have Mr. James Iha on lead vocals. And James also wrote Take Me Down. And I was wearing my Portal to the Cat Dimension t-shirt. And Take Me Down to the Underground, you know, I think there could be some Cat Dimension, or yeah, Cat Dimension in the underground, right? I'm just being silly right now. But that's what we're going to be doing and listening to. I'm going to be sharing my thoughts and my feels on Take Me Down by the Smashing Pumpkins from Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. We're jumping into it in just 1 second. But before we do, if you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on Odyssey, follow the channel. You can gently caress the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. Leave me a like, leave me a comment. If you want to give my pumpkins session a little cash injection, you can always go buy something from my Macari store. Lots of cool vibes over there. Sustainable, cool vibes. Check it out. Go to your social things. Find me on my social things. The X thing, the Threads thing, but especially the Insta thing. Alright guys, we're going to be listening to the album version of Take Me Down because honestly, there's just not that many great live performances of this out there on the line. You know, it was played live here and there in like mid-late 90s, but it was the mid to late 90s and people's, you know, portable cameras were not all that amazing. And so the few videos that I can find that are live, Take Me Down, James singing, are just really poor quality. So album version to the rescue, and maybe one day somebody will drop me one that is a really good one, or maybe in the future we'll have Take Me Down as part of the set list and we'll get to hear James sing it again. Very possibly, because I mean, we're coming up on the 30th anniversary of Melancholy, so that wouldn't surprise me if we get a James vocal on a there's got to be some type of Melancholy commemorative 30th anniversary tour or something, combination of a Gory Mori, I don't know, we'll see. But this is not a very long song. Like I said, it's an easy song. It's one of those that it's sort of a lullaby almost. And as I mentioned earlier, it's special because, you know, we have Mr. James Iha on vocals. So without further ado, Take Me Down. Okay, before we get into the lyrics, I know you guys hate when I stop so soon, but these intros are just so great. And, you know, from the first notes, you know, you get those first, like, strums that sound kind of like harpy or like harpsichordy. Like, they just melt me. I feel this wave of, like, calm almost, you know? And you've got the underlying beat that's just very, very consistent. It's moving forward underneath it, but then you have these strums and it feels like there's something like angelic about it. Also, maybe it's because it's that harpy kind of sound. And you think harps and angels and cherubs, but I just feel like I should be like floating on a cloud with some cherubs flying around, you know, up to this point. So let's get into Mr. Iha's lyrics.
Take me down to the underground.
God, this song really is almost like a lullaby. You know, it just rocks you in to this place that you can't get to without something like this, like pulling you in. It's almost ASMR-y, you know what I'm saying? Let's talk lyrics really quick. Okay, starts out, "Take me down to the underground. Won't you take me down to the underground?" And of course, you're thinking, like, okay, take me down to the underground. We're going into this deep, dark, kind of scary place. Oh no, this underground is like, it might be deep and dark, but it's your like warmth, it's your comfort, it's your deep, dark, safe space. And why, oh why, there is no light. And if I can't sleep, can you hold my life? Like hold me in the dark. And like maybe it is a little dark, but it's not an unsettling dark, you know? This song so much, and like some people love James's singing voice, some people hate James's singing voice. I love all James vocal songs, much like with Billy, either you love his voice or you hate his voice. But I think James always does a good job, especially when he's picking cover songs, of choosing things that are good in his range, and he writes for his voice too. We have these parts where they get a little high and it gets a little shaky, but that's almost like part of the like enchantment of the song. That's what like that like James's vocals and getting up in those high parts and it getting a little shaky is almost endearing. You know what I mean? And let's revisit the whole, you know, like I was talking about, like the take me down to the underground, where it's not necessarily like a scary place or like a dark place. I think I need to like clarify a little bit. Like, it might be a dark place, but it is, take me there so, you know, you can be my safe space. So you can hold my life and then be the light and the sun that comes. You understand what I'm saying? Sometimes I don't feel like I articulate as well as I think I do, and I'm trying to do better on that. Tell me that is a track that is on the same album, not even just the same album, but the same disc of the same album as Bullet with Butterfly Wings and Fuck You and Ode to No One. You know, that is why Melancholy is such an amazing album. Like, you know, we have Bullet Butterfly Wings, we have an Ode to No One, we have Here Is No Why, you know, all of these angsty, ragey bangers. And then this disc, the first disc of Melancholy, you know, it wraps up with Take Me Down. And I just know back when I was oh so very young, listening to Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness for the very first time, and you go from, you know, full orchestra tonight, And then, like, balls to the wall, like, angsty, ragey bullet butterfly wings. And then these grandiose tracks, like, the angsty, grandiose bangers, like, An Ode's No One and Here Is No Why. But then you get, like, you wrap it up with, like, Take Me Down. Like, what is this? I remember thinking, how does this all work so well together? Why does this make so much sense? And you know, I've spent most of my life really trying to figure that out. Like, it does. This is one of the reasons I have this channel. It's my stage for me to share out my thoughts and make sense of all this music that has meant so much to me and that I've loved so much throughout my life. And you know, I'm constantly like, pumpkins are my emotional support, and I'm constantly working through all the feelings that they stir and how, like, the feelings they allow me to have that allow me to cope in whatever way and whatever's going on, and why these albums that are so unique and, like, on the surface really shouldn't make sense, but they do. And why does that impact me so deeply? You know, like, I don't know. I know my pumpkin people, you guys get it. I know the casual fans, maybe not so much. And then, you know, there's a few haters out there here and there that come on and say ugly stuff, but we don't care about that. We don't care about y'all. I don't know. It's just, it really is, like, epic. Okay, it is. And Take Me Down, like, such a amazing, calming way to end the first album, Dusk Till Dawn, on Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. We had to get the last little bit of the song done
Dawn
there.
till dusk.
Did I just say Dusk Till Dawn? I can't remember what I said. Dawn till dusk. Dusk Till Dawn is a Quentin Tarantino vampire movie, which I also really like, but it's not nearly as amazing as Melancholy and the Infinite Sadness. So if I misspoke there, I don't even remember what I said. My apologies. Okay, anyway. Okay, Take Me Down. I've already kind of rambled out my intro there right before the end of the song. My outro, rather. I'm getting all tongue-tied now. I've used up all the good things I have to say. Take Me Down, a James Iha, like, original. You know, Billy has writing credits for this song in the liner notes too, I think. But I think Billy has writing credits on all of the tracks. But it's just, like I said, it's such a, like, grounding, relaxing, calming way to end the first disc of Melancholy. What do you guys think of this song? Is this one of the ones you love? Is this one of those, like, you know, like, fan favorites, hardcore fan favorites? I think there's some people that love anything James does, and this is certainly a song written by the same guy that wrote Blew Away, you know? But let me know all of your Take Me Down thoughts and feels down in the comments below. And that's it for today. I am Asherella. This is Original Asherella. If you're watching on YouTube, subscribe to the channel. If you're watching on Odyssey, follow the channel. You can gently press the notification bell on either platform so you know every time I upload a video. Leave me a like, leave me a comment. You can buy me a coffee. You can go purchase something from my Mercari store. Link is down in the description as well. Go to your social things. Find me on my social things, the X thing, the Thread things, but especially the Insta thing. Go to Twitch, find Original Asherella on Twitch, and then tune in on Sundays for Kino and commentary, 8-ish Eastern Standard Time. Always tap in, never tap out, and don't forget to keep on smashing like a pumpkin.
You.